Hello guys, one more mission like usually. We received a Pajero, Mitsubishi Pajero 2012 V6 engine. We can see that they towed the vehicle, with a recovery, let's say, they brought the vehicle exactly like that. The only thing that we start doing, because I realized that the timing is not correct, we try to correct the timing. Now, and there is, for this reason, the purpose of the video is not the timing. The purpose of the video is that some jobs, they might have traps. So, to don't spoil the relationship between your customer, you have to be very accurate and very careful how you are reply to the customer, how give him explanations, because now what happened in my own case, now this vehicle have been in another workshop probably, or I don't know exactly the history, but I know that the vehicle came with a recover and we start working on it. By the way, as I saw the vehicle, I say two things: or they can't find the, they can't make timing alignment, or they are doing timing alignment and the engine have inside to the cylinder problem, maybe valve, maybe broken a ring on the piston and is losing compression and they can't crank the engine. By the way, I never reached there. I will take it step by step. First priority that I give is to correct the alignment of the vehicle. Now, the fact is that I find that this is the adjuster from the timing belt, it cranked. As it cranked, we have the, except that it's bent, this is the first. Second is lose the power to tension with the correct way the belt, because we have oil leakage. If I put it on the vise now, for instance, to press it and put the pin, let's say that we are using, how easy is going? This is abnormal. It's going very easy. Now, if I use this tensioner, for instance, let's say that I don't observe some things and I use this tensioner, I say, okay, this one, it will not affect me, or it will not give me any problem. You know, I will try to rush the job. Definitely, it will affect, because first of all, it can tension the belt. Normally, we're supposed to press it, but not so easy. Sometimes it require, maybe, sometimes I used to use my press. But in this case, just I want to show you how easy it is. I don't even apply power to the vise. So by the time that, let's say that you put your pin, you make your timing, you want to assemble the components of the vehicle, it will start running some tests. Definitely you will jump the teeth. 95%, I'm sure, with this kind of adjuster, it's possible that the time that you are cranking the engine, you can jump this. And actually, when we did the correction of the alignment, we have two teeth different. Now, second observation, radiator. We have leakage. Now, where is the trap? I want to explain you. First of all, the vehicle comes with a recover. Second of all, the owner of the vehicle asked me to do general inspection. I did my general inspection, and when I reached to the engine site, I noticed some things. I stopped my inspection and I contact with my client. I try to make, because he's a busy person, let's say, he can't come. So I will be able to show him direct what is going. So I try with a video, pictures and some things to give him informations. So now, by my own informations and technical explanations, I make him to understand on one point, on one spec, what I want to do. Because a lot of people, they complain, workshops, they don't allow to enter. I'm not supporting the customer to be inside the workshop, 100%. It's not correct. First of all, it's a matter of safety. But because I work to a lot of different authorized dealers as a workshop manager or service manager, I used to, with a special permit, let's say under my own permission, the owners of the vehicle, because this is the only way that you can prove yourself as a technician, let's say. Sometimes people start suspecting, they start thinking maybe you try to cheat them, because a lot of jobs that you are doing on the vehicles, they are blind jobs for somebody that don't have technical knowledges. So it's good to communicate with the customer. It's very important thing to allow him to know what is going on. Second, it's good, don't blame somebody that did a mistake. It's not professional to blame a colleague, let's say. Now, maybe this mistake come from the mechanic that worked before. It's good to avoid these kind of things. The point is that we need to fix the car. We don't start opening conversation that this thing is costing because of him or this, or direct straight to the point. Explanations, give him what is your own opinion, give him options to choose. So definitely in my own case, I need to do, I will run also a compression test with a compressiometer. I want to see to shortcut the job, because for me now to open valve covers, start checking the valves, turning the engine, how the arms, the rocket arms and etc., pressing the valves, it's not something accurate. The most accurate way is to take a compressiometer and start cracking the engine. But now, because of this crank, I have a fear to don't jump a teeth. Anyway, we'll see how we can do it. Except that it's not only to jump, you don't have a tool. Maybe I will try to assist somehow the bearing to do something there, just for, because to crank, we need to make a compression test, we need the speed of the kickstarter. So probably I will remove all the spark blocks, so the engine don't have load. And with this way, I will run my test. But the major thing is that we have to communicate every time with the owner of the vehicle. It's very important thing. So thank you very much for watching me, and we'll come back with a new mission. Thank you.